Now, today once again, I am trying to explain how to balance a chemical equation, because some of you are facing a little bit of problem to understand it. So let's take the example of this reaction. This is a skeleton reaction. It is not balanced. Only the name of the reactants and the products are here. Sodium reacting with water to form sodium hydroxide and hydrogen. Now the problem here, you see, the sodium atom in the left side, number of sodium atoms is 1. In the right hand side, means in the product side, it is also 1. So no problem. Here you see the oxygen atom, the left hand side is 1. In the right hand side, it is also 1. So there is also no problem. But the problem here is that there are 2 hydrogen atoms in the product reactant side, whereas in the product side there are 3. Here is 1 and here is 2. So we have to make it equal in both the sides. So how to do? So 2 means here it is 2. So either we have to make in the right hand side it is a multiple of 2, or in the left hand side it is a multiple of 2. So let's do, if I do here in the left hand side, if I put 2 starting from the minimum number, it will be 4 hydrogen atoms. So not only 4 hydrogen atoms, oxygen number of oxygen atoms will be also 2. So let's put, if I put 2 here, it is, if I put 2 here, here you see the number of hydrogen atoms has become 4. 2 2s are 4. Oxygen atoms 2. Now the problem is that here it is 3. 1 plus 2 3. So if I put 2 here, it will become, here you see, 2 hydrogen atoms plus 2 hydrogen atoms, 4. It has become equal now. Here you see oxygen atoms, 2. 2 ones are 2. Here is also 2. So the problem regarding hydrogen and oxygen atom is over. But the problem has started here. Now the sodium ion, the atom has become, number of sodium atom has become 2. So to make it equal, we have to put 1, 2 here. Now you see the equation. Number of sodium atoms 2, it is equal to 2. Number of, total number of hydrogen atoms in the left side is 2, 2 are 4. Here you see 2 ones are 2, here it is 2, and here it is 2. So 2 plus 2, 4. Number of oxygen atoms, here it is in the left side 2, on the right hand side it is also 2. So we can tell that the equation is balanced now. Let's move to another example. Potassium chlorate KClO3 decomposed to potassium chloride and oxygen. No problem with potassium. Here it is 1, here it is also 1. No problem with chlorine. Here it is 1, here it is also 1. No problem. But the oxygen atoms here in the left side, it is 3, but here it is 2. So we have to derive to a multiple of 2 of oxygen atoms, so they both side they becomes equal. So the next multiple of 2 here can be, if I put 2 here, the minimum number, it will be 4. But in no way this 3 cannot be a multiple of 2, or we cannot be reached to 4. So if I move to the next number 3, if I put 3 here, you see 3 2s are 6 oxygen atoms. So to equalize it, if I put here 2, here you see 2 3s are 6, 2 3s are 6, 3 2s are 6, it is now equal. But now the problem comes here, the potassium is 2, here is 1, chlorine is also 2, it is also 1, no problem, just put 2 here. Now check it, potassium atoms 2, 2 potassium atoms, here putting 2 in front of this means this number will be multiplied by, here it is 1, nothing means 1, multiplied by this one, it will be multiplied by this one, and these 2 will be multiplied by this one. So here you see the number of potassium atoms are 2, chlorine atoms are also 2, and oxygen atoms 2 into 3, 6, 3 into 2, 6. So the equation is balanced. Let's move to another equation. Let's go to this one, fourth one. Nitric oxide reacting with oxygen to form nitrogen dioxide. No problem with nitrogen, one atom, here is also one atom. The problem is there is 1 plus 2, 3 atoms of oxygen, here is 2. So obviously we have to make it 4. Let's see how can by permutation method. If I put 2 here, here you see the number of oxygen atoms have become 2, 2 into 1, nothing means here it is 1, 2 into 1, 2, plus 2, 4. So to make it 4, if I put 2 here, it will become 2 into 2, 4. Number of nitrogen atoms, 2, here is also 2. Left hand side oxygen, 2 into 1, 2, plus 2, means here nothing means 1 is there, 2, 4 oxygen atoms, here you see 4 oxygen atoms, 2 nitrogen atoms. Putting the coefficient 2 here means always think about this compound, it will be multiplied by this one also, multiply these 2 will be multiplied by this one also, the subscript. So the equation is balanced. Now here this one is a very simple one, N2 plus O2 reacting to form NO, nitric oxide. Here it is 2, here it is also 2. So very simple way, if I put 2 here, 2 nitrogen and 2 oxygen. So the equation is balanced. Keep in mind, there is no specific rule to balance the chemical equations. By this way, by permutation and combination, you have to balance the chemical equations.